The United States Space Force has taken a significant step forward in developing its Space-Based Interceptor, SBI program, with the release of a request for prototype proposal. The solicitation seeks multiple industry partners to design and deliver functional prototype systems, marking the beginning of a new phase in space-based missile defense development. The solicitation was officially made public on October 4th. The SBI program forms part of America's broader investment in building the world's most advanced layered missile defense architecture. Unlike traditional land-based interceptors, space-based systems would orbit the Earth and engage ballistic missiles in their early flight stages, offering a faster and more flexible defensive response. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes how U.S. military is pushing ahead with space-based interceptor program. Before we proceed, a word on NordVPN, which is one of the most trusted and fastest VPN brand that has a no-log policy validated by Deloitte. NordVPN provides a 256-bit encrypted tunnel that protects your privacy and also enables you to access contents that are blocked based on geolocation. Its threat protection system helps you avoid phishing, scams, and malware. NordVPN application is available for all the major platforms as well as browsers. Get an exclusive NordVPN deal with massive saving by going to nordvpn.com/defense or clicking the link in the description. It's risk-free with Nord's 30-day money-back guarantee. The Space-Based Interceptor, SBI, project stands as one of the most ambitious elements of America's missile defense modernization efforts, with the potential to significantly reshape the global balance of power between the United States and its principal strategic rivals, China, Russia, and North Korea. It is a key component of the proposed Golden Dome Initiative. As part of a broader drive to establish a multi-layered missile defense network, the SBI program aims to neutralize threats in their earliest phases of flight. Operating in orbit above the Earth's atmosphere, a constellation of space-based interceptors would be designed to detect and destroy ballistic and hypersonic missiles before they can reach their targets, a capability deemed increasingly vital amid the rapid evolution of adversary missile technologies. The program seeks to enable interception during the boost phase, when missiles are most vulnerable but currently remain beyond the reach of existing systems. This initiative directly addresses the growing challenge posed by next-generation hypersonic weapons being developed by China, Russia, and North Korea. Weapons capable of maneuvering unpredictably and evading conventional defenses. Viewers may note that in 2021, Chinese military grabbed international attention by testing the DFCF, a hypersonic glide vehicle, HGV, that reportedly circumnavigated the globe, underscoring the urgency for U.S. countermeasures. HGV are less susceptible to anti-ballistic missile countermeasures than conventional missiles. The DFZF, which is thought to reach speeds between Mach 5 to 10, could be used for nuclear weapons delivery, but could also be used to perform conventional precision strike missions. By engaging such missiles before they accelerate beyond the atmosphere, the SBI offers a potentially game-changing approach to missile defense. The solicitation was released by the Space Systems Command's Space Combat Power Program Executive Office and calls for multiple industry partners to design and deliver prototype interceptor systems. As per Department of War, the awards will be structured as fixed-price other transaction agreements under 10 U.S. Code 4022 and may also incorporate prize competitions authorized under 10 U.S. Code 4025. In a notice released on October 4th, the Space Force said the request for proposal shall not be construed as an obligation on the part of the government and does not commit the government to making any awards. Instead, the solicitation is aimed at attracting competitive proposals from companies capable of delivering new interceptor technologies for deployment in orbit. Access to the solicitation's detailed technical materials, collectively referred to as the Bidder's Library, is limited to companies authorized to handle controlled technical data. To qualify, firms must submit a valid DD Form 2345, the Militarily Critical Technical Data Agreement, processed through the Defense Logistics Agency's Joint Certification Program. Once certified, approved companies may request additional documentation and classified materials through secure communication channels. The notice further stated that eligible companies may optionally provide JWICS points of contact to receive the supplementary classified information presented during the USS FSBI Industry Day to better inform their proposed approaches. The government's verification process typically requires 1 to 2 business days after all necessary documentation has been submitted. The deadline for companies to request access to the bidder's library was set for September 24, 2025, with final proposal submissions due by October 2nd. The Space Force also confirmed that non-government personnel will participate in evaluating proposal submissions. The announcement stated, "Interested parties are advised that the government intends to utilize non-government personnel in the review and analysis of all submitted feedback and proposals. These individuals may include experts from federally funded research and development centers, systems engineering and integration organizations, and systems engineering and technical assistance contractors providing technical and acquisition support." This initiative marks a significant evolution in the Pentagon's approach to space, signaling a transition from viewing it solely as a domain for surveillance, communications, and command and control to treating it as an active theater for defense operations. It also runs parallel to other emerging space warfare programs, including exploratory efforts to develop space-based combat aircraft capable of conducting missions such as strategic bombing. The Space-Based Interceptor, SBI, program stands as one of the most ambitious pillars of U.S. missile defense modernization, potentially extending the nation's defensive envelope well beyond terrestrial and airborne systems. Although specific interceptor designs remain classified, the program highlights the Pentagon's strategic shift toward integrating space as a fully operational defense domain. If realized, the SBI constellation could establish a persistent orbital layer capable of engaging missile threats during their boost phase, a long-sought capability. It is interesting to note that industry partners are already working on this in the background. In August, Amanda Pound, Director of Advanced Programs Development at Lockheed Martin, said, "I believe, based on the sheer numbers they're asking about, it's going to take more than just one big prime contractor. It might take multiple of us, as well as a lot of the rest of the industry." Pound added further, "The goal is to field an on-orbit demonstration of a space-based interceptor by 2028. We have the capability to do that. We're ready to support." It is clear that Space-Based Interceptor is poised for strong push.